All right, so Fred, tell us, you know, why you wanted to come down tonight, why you wanted to be a part of this whole event for Jim.
Well, that's kind of obvious. You know, when you work with somebody, you create a camaraderie. We did three pictures together, so that was a great deal of camaraderie between all of us, between me, him, and Jim Brown. So, you know, you come in and pay your respect, because one day it's going to be us, and we hope that somebody do the same for us.
I'm sure you have so many different great moments with him, but what's one thing that kind of just sticks out? And it may not be a moment, but just something he said or something he did that you're going to take with you after.
Yeah, I'm going to always take for him his girlish sounds. That's what I'm taking. That's what I remember about Jim.
And you've had a very successful career, not only in football, but of course in acting. You know, what has been one of the highlight moments of your career? You know, you still got a lot of years ahead of you, but looking back, what's some of the good things that you remember?
Well, there's only one highlight good for my career is that I've taken charge of my career. All the movies that I do now are produced by me, directed by me, and most of them are written by me. So once you take charge of your own career, then that's maxed out.
What about, you know, the years that you've been able to be not only, you know, you kind of been able to tie in two of your different loves of martial arts and of movies. You know, what is your advice for up and coming actors? Because now you've been able to take on a behind the scenes role as well. So what is your advice to young actors coming up?
My advice to young actors is get another job.
Have a backup job or don't do it at all.
Get another job.
You know, you've been successful.
Yeah, because, you know, I took the blows, you know. I mean, I came up when it was really hard. Yeah. Being black was a motivation for me. Some people don't have that fortitude because you got more people telling you what you can't do than what you can do. So it takes a real strong fortitude, especially if you're black. But then, you know, I'm the hammer, so that's what I look forward to, being pushed against the wall.
And did Jim ever talk about, you know, being in martial arts and being African-American was never easy. So did he ever kind of talk about the barriers that he kind of broke down, being African-American and playing, you know, roles as a martial artist?
No, but Jim had a mission, you know, and that's what everybody has to have. You have to have a purpose and a mission, no matter what you do or what color you are. He had a mission. His mission was to be in the entertainment world, and he found through the dedication that he put into martial arts that he could get himself into the movie industry by being a master martial artist. And it worked for him.
And then lastly, what do you want to say about Jim to everybody that couldn't be here today? Like, what's something you want to leave us with?
Hard work, determination. That's what Jim was all about, and that's why he became a success.
All right, thank you. Anything exciting coming up in the next couple years that you want to talk about? Or?
My whole life is so exciting. I don't know how much time you got, man. I got four movies coming out. I work more in Europe now than I do here. And in America, I'm a black actor. In Europe, I'm an action star. So I just finished a movie in Germany, finished a movie in Italy, finished one in Montreal, and I'm going back to Germany in about a couple of weeks. So over there, I'm a big action star. I'm like Clint Eastwood with martial arts over there. So in America, I'm a black actor, you know.
Well, hopefully America will wake up.
That'll be the day. Who said that? That'll be the day.
Absolutely.
John Wayne.
Absolutely. Yeah, long